You heard that right. Thousands of beavers once flew over the Idaho desert under parachutes. And it wasn't a circus stunt at all. It was part of a grand plan by scientists to turn a dry wasteland into a flourishing oasis. Imagine furry ecosystem engineers beginning their new mission from a bird's eye view. In this video, you'll see how such wild ideas can become the driving force behind restoring nature. A story that will definitely give you goosebumps and truly surprise you. The tale of the parachuting beavers is about how Americans used beaver paratroopers to save an ecosystem. In the 1940s, officials in Idaho decided to gather the beaver population and relocate them to remote areas to improve the landscape and restore the ecosystem. This unconventional solution became part of a large-scale environmental protection initiative. Now, nearly 70 years later, NASA satellite images have revealed astonishing results. The areas where the beavers were relocated became significantly greener and more lush. These regions not only took on a new appearance, but also became more resilient to natural disasters such as fires and droughts. According to EarthSky, the impact of beavers on the ecosystem turned out to be much deeper than initially expected. By building dams and ponds, beavers contributed to increased biodiversity, as the new bodies of water attracted many other species of animals and plants. This became a great example of how a single action can trigger a chain reaction of changes in nature. The story of the parachuting beavers vividly demonstrates the importance of ecosystem restoration and shows how humanity can use natural mechanisms to improve the state of the environment. A rain of beavers. Some areas were so remote from human settlements that there simply were no roads. Local authorities faced this problem and came up with an original solution. The Idaho Fish and Game Company decided to use parachutes left over from World War II to drop beavers directly into their new homes. This unusual and bold solution attracted a lot of attention. Initially, fishermen and hunters decided that beavers should be placed in woven willow crates. They believed that the rodents would be able to know their own way to freedom after landing. However, this plan did not work. The beavers didn't want to wait and quickly broke out of the crates before even landing. This created additional difficulties and forced the authorities to look for another solution. In response to this problem, specialists from Idaho Fish and Game developed a special case that opens upon impact with the ground. The experts decided to test the new design on one impatient beaver named Geronimo. After several successful trial drops in the field, they became confident in the effectiveness of the design and its ability to ensure the animal's safety during release. This experience became an important step in the unique beaver relocation operation, which led to the successful restoration of ecosystems in remote areas. Thus, a real rain of beavers broke out over Idaho. The project to relocate these rodents continued until 1948. Today, their descendants inhabit a part of the largest protected roadless forest, which stretches across 48 states of the USA. Evidence from space. Thus, a real rain of beavers broke out over Idaho, which became a symbol of a successful ecological initiative. The project to relocate these rodents continued until 1948, and its results amazed many. Today, the descendants of those beavers inhabit a part of the largest protected roadless forest, which stretches across 48 states in the USA. When you compare a section of a stream where beavers have built their lodges with a neighboring stream where these animals are absent, the difference becomes obvious. Areas inhabited by beavers look much greener and more lush, with wide bands of vegetation which indicates the positive impact these animals have on the environment. In 2018, a severe fire destroyed more than 60,000 acres of land in the Bow Creek area. However, images taken after this catastrophic event showed that the lush and moist areas around beaver dams remained virtually untouched by the fire. So, what conclusion can we draw? Modern NASA satellite images confirm that the plan to improve the ecosystem with parachuting beavers was successful and produced impressive results, demonstrating how a single action can significantly change and improve the state of nature. What would a beaver do in the Arabian desert? Beavers could adapt by adding seeds and fruits of local drought-resistant plants to their diet, which would help them get the necessary nutrients. Using their skills, beavers could create artificial water sources by finding rare streams or oases to form small ponds, which would provide them with drinking water. In the hot desert conditions, beavers could build shelters from natural materials to protect themselves from the sun and reduce the risk of overheating. Beavers would need to cooperate with local animals such as rodents or birds to find food and water, which would help them survive in the new environment. Learning and adaptation would be the key factors for survival. Beavers could study the local conditions and develop strategies for finding food and shelter. Although beavers are not typical desert dwellers, their ability to adapt could help them survive in the Arabian desert by changing their diet, creating water sources, building shelters, and cooperating with other species. Dixie Creek. At the end of the 1980s, biologists raised the alarm. prolonged heat and people's neglect of nature led to the drying up of Dixie Creek. After analyzing the situation, experts recommended that farmers change their approach to grazing livestock. Now, animals were forbidden from being near the creek, which allowed the riparian vegetation previously subjected to negative impacts to recover. Beavers became the true heroes of the ecosystem. They skillfully built dams on bodies of water, which helps them protect themselves from predators and obtain food. These structures slow down the flow of water, which in turn has a positive effect on the riparian vegetation. Grasses, flowers, and shrubs begin to thrive. Thus, beavers not only create comfortable conditions for themselves, but also contribute to the restoration of the surrounding environment. The dams on Dixie Creek played a key role in increasing the number of fish, aquatic animals, and plants. As a result, the creek was fully restored, and its banks were transformed into a green oasis. Wild animals and birds began to come regularly to drink water. For a southern state with a desert climate, this became a true natural wonder. Damn! The oldest dam was discovered by scientists in 2005, and according to preliminary estimates, it may have been built about 125,000 years ago. These animals use only natural materials: trees, branches, grass, silt, stones, and mud. Olga Gorolovskaya, a biologist and staff member of the Kershensky State Nature Biosphere Reserve, explains why beavers build their dams. Beavers live in lodges that rise above the water level. To protect their homes from predators such as foxes, wolves, lynxes, and owls, the entrance must be underwater. That is why beavers use dams to maintain a high water level in rivers and streams. Biologist Alexandra Nikolainkova also spoke about the positive impact beavers have on the environment. The dams built by beavers have a significant effect on ecosystems. New ponds are formed, riverbeds change, and even the flow of rivers is altered. The areas transformed by beaver activity are sometimes called beaver landscapes. In their habitats, beavers not only build dams, but also dig burrows, make trails, and create canals. By forming colonies, over the course of 3 decades, they not only saved the stream in the Wild West, but also completely restored it, along with an entire ecosystem in the arid desert. A problem with their diet. There was not enough vegetation in the desert to serve as food for the beavers. Taking this into account, the scientists decided to change the beavers' diet by adding seeds and fruits of local plants. This change was necessary to provide the beavers with enough nutrients and to help them adapt to the conditions they found themselves in. The beavers quickly got used to the new diet and began to reproduce actively, which surprised the researchers. The scientists were amazed by the beavers' ability to adapt to such extreme conditions which they had never lived in before. This demonstrated that beavers have a high degree of flexibility in their food choices and can adapt to changing circumstances. The experiment continued for several months, and the results were simply impressive. The beavers not only survived in the desert, but also successfully adapted to the new conditions, beginning to build dams and create new bodies of water. This study showed that beavers are incredibly resilient and adaptable animals capable of surviving in the most extreme conditions and changing their lives depending on their environment. Their example is inspiring and demonstrates how important it is to preserve biodiversity and support ecosystems. Criticism. Undoubtedly, this experiment raised many questions and sparked debates within the scientific community. Some scientists voiced their criticism, believing that such approaches are impractical and unethical, since subjecting animals to such trials may be wrong. They raised important questions about the moral responsibility of researchers and how such experiments might affect animal welfare. On the other hand, many scientists viewed this experiment as a unique opportunity to study the remarkable ability of animals to adapt to changes in their environment. They believed that such research could lead to important discoveries that would help us better understand the mechanisms of survival and behavioral changes in animals in response to extreme conditions. During the discussion, various opinions emerged. Some researchers emphasized the importance of ethical standards in conducting experiments, while others, on the contrary, focused on the scientific value of the information obtained. This dialogue became an important part of the scientific process, prompting scientists to reflect more deeply on research methods and their consequences. Ultimately, this experiment opened new horizons in understanding animal ecology and behavior, becoming a valuable contribution to science. Beavers in Antarctica. The largest desert in the world is Antarctica. Although deserts are often associated with hot and dry climates, Antarctica is considered a cold desert because it is characterized by extremely low precipitation and vast barren areas. Imagine an astonishing scenario. Beavers, known for their building skills and ability to alter ecosystems, settling in Antarctica. What kind of impact could this have on this cold and harsh continent? The first thing to note would be the change in the landscape. Beavers would start building dams on rivers and streams, creating artificial bodies of water. These dams would slow the flow of water, which would contribute to the formation of ponds and wetlands. As a result, the area around the bodies of water would become more humid and greener. This could lead to the emergence of new ecosystems, where other species of animals and plants currently absent from Antarctica would begin to inhabit. However, with the increase in vegetation and bodies of water, new challenges would also arise. By building their dams, beavers could alter the natural balance of the ecosystem, which would affect the existing species. Some animals, such as seals and penguins, might face difficulties finding food due to changes in their habitat. This would create a need for research and monitoring to understand how the new conditions affect the local fauna. By observing the behavior of beavers and their impact on the environment, scientists could gain insight into how climate change affects ecosystems. If beavers were to settle in Antarctica, it could lead to significant changes in the continent's landscape and ecosystem. On the one hand, they could contribute to increased biodiversity and the creation of new bodies of water. On the other hand, their presence could cause problems for existing species. This scenario highlights the importance of understanding the interconnections within ecosystems and how a single change can affect the entire environment. Beavers are small-scale ecosystem engineers. They help restore natural landscapes, making them potential allies in environmental conservation efforts. I hope you learned a lot of new and interesting things from this video. Do you want to surprise and delight people? Join our team. We create content that inspires. If you know how to edit videos, do voiceovers, or write engaging scripts, we'd be happy to have you on our team. Message our Telegram bot, and let's make the world brighter together.